Hi there, welcome back to Going to Ground with me, Andrew Rumsey. And here in Britain, it's Armistice Day, the 11th of November, when we recall the end of hostilities at the close of the First World War. And this morning in our Bishop's staff meeting, we paused, as many people will have done around the country, for 2 minutes silence to remember those who have lost their lives in conflict in one way or another and in military service. But this afternoon, I'm amid the rusting autumnal glory of the Savernake Forest in Wiltshire. And I filmed here about 3 weeks ago on a Saturday, a misty Saturday morning, when it was a bit greener. But now the colours are deepening into this lovely bronze and yellow, and everything is mouldering around us at this point in the autumn. I've just trodden in something that just sort of sank down beneath me. It begins to, by mid-November in the forest, everything softens and becomes soggy and decomposing down into the winter. And the leaves, of course, about half fallen, I suppose. Today in the Church of England's calendar, we recall somebody called St. Martin of Tours, who died, it's thought, in 397 AD. And somebody who is, it's appropriate to remember him on a day of military remembrance, because he was, before he was the bishop, a third bishop of Tours in present day France, he was a Roman soldier serving as a legionary, I think, as a teenager. And the legend has it that he was stationed in Gaul in France and encountered one day a ragged beggar. And in an act of impulsive charity, he whisked off his cloak, used his sword to slice it in half, and gave one half to the beggar. He then had a dream that night of Christ himself wearing the half cloak that he'd given to the beggar, saying, "Martin gave me this." And other legends around the same story have him arising the next morning to find that his cloak has been made whole again. Now, that was a fairly simple story of charity that became the basis of a miraculous legacy that saw the relic of his cloak, his little cloak, being carried around into battle. And it was venerated and amazingly, I had no idea of this, you may know the story, but as it was carried around with the armies, it was housed in little booths called capella, and that capella is a half cloak, a little cloak, for the half cloak that he had left, reputedly after giving the other half away. And from that word capella, we get chapel. So chapel means little cloak, and henceforth, all priests who also served in the military were known as, I think, capellani or something like that, which became chaplain. And of course, those are both words, chapel and chaplain, that we continue using to this day. Is that incredible? It means little cloak. And all of that grew from an everyday act of charity. I mean, that impresses upon me, I guess, two things really. Not only a reminder of the care and relief and charity that chaplains offer in their work, in not only in the military, but of course in hospitals and schools and all kinds of places, but also of the contagious power of miracle in the life of the early church, and how it became a means of growing faith and of seeing that kind of expectation that that God was miraculously at work in the everyday things, and we're perhaps less ready to see that and to see his hand in an ordinary decision, albeit a generous one, to help a beggar in the street. Food for thought, and a good remembrance for this day. And I'm going to have a little walk around the forest a bit more to just get a break. And I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. And we'll be in, I don't know where we'll be tomorrow, but either in a church or in a field or in the forest. God bless you wherever you are as you go to ground.